theory of planned behavior explains human behavior from the perspective of intentions. This theory was proposed by Icek Ajzen. First, what are intentions? Intentions are assumed to capture the motivational factors that influence a behavior. They are indications of how hard people are willing to try, of how much an effort they are planning to exert in order to perform the behavior. As a general rule, the stronger the intention to engage a behavior, the more likely should be its performance. If intentions are so important to predict a human behavior, then how to predict intentions? According to the theory of planned behavior, our intentions to perform behaviors can be predicted from three factors: our attitudes toward the behavior, subjective norms, and perceived behavioral control. First, attitudes toward the behavior are a function of readily accessible beliefs regarding the behavior's likely consequences. Those beliefs are called behavioral beliefs. A behavioral belief is the person's subjective probability that performing a behavior will lead to a certain outcome or provide a certain experience. For example, to cast a vote no in the committee I serve, I consider how important my vote of no is for the final outcome. If the majority of committee members have indicated that they would vote yes, then my vote of no may not have an important impact on the final outcome, which is the majority vote. Here, my belief of how important my vote is for the final outcome influences my intention, which ultimately influences my behavior, that is, how I vote in the committee. Second, subjective norm refers to the perceived social pressure to perform or not to perform the behavior. For example, even though I, not my supervisor, is the one with the voting power in the committee, but my supervisor and my supervisor's supervisor have made it clear, both explicitly and implicitly, that they want my vote to be yes. Deep down in my heart, I believe that voting yes is morally wrong. But my belief that my vote of no would be disapproved by my supervisor and my supervisor's supervisor influences my intention to comply with them. The social pressure from the organizational hierarchy and power holders' preference can influence my intention and ultimately my behavior in the committee. Third, perceived behavioral control refers to the perceived ease or difficulty of performing the behavior, and it is assumed to reflect past experience as well as anticipated impediments and obstacles. Control factors could be required skills, availability or lack of time, money, cooperation by other people, and many others. A control belief is defined as a person's subjective probability that a given facilitating or inhibiting factor will be present in the situation of interest. For example, the decision of my promotion will be made right after I cast a vote in the committee. To be promoted, I need the support from my supervisor and my supervisor's supervisor. So I have less perceived behavioral control than the case in which the decision of my promotion will be made in 5 years. In addition to the three factors of intentions, there is a feedback effect. After we behave in a certain way, reactions from others can influence our attitudes, subjective norms, and perceived behavioral controls, which influence future intentions. Like all theories, the theory of planned behavior is not perfect. If you want to advance this theory, how would you start? You may find the definition of perceived behavioral control is similar to self-efficacy. Do the constructs mean the same thing? In fact, in the article titled The Theory of Planned Behavior, Frequently Asked Questions, Icek Ajzen, who proposed the theory of planned behavior, acknowledged that conceptually there is no difference between perceived behavioral control and self-efficacy. Both refer to people's beliefs that they are capable of performing a given behavior. But Ajzen added, operationally, however, perceived behavioral control and self-efficacy are usually assessed in different ways. For example, in Ajzen's proposed questionnaire of the theory of planned behavior, the targeted behavior is exercising for at least 20 minutes, 3 times a week for the next 3 months. In this questionnaire, perceived behavioral control is measured by 2 items. The first item is, I am confident that I can exercise for at least 20 minutes 3 times per week for the next 3 months. And the second item is, my exercising for at least 20 minutes 3 times per week for the next 3 months is up to me. By contrast, Bandura's self-efficacy is measured by 4 dimensions. They are performance accomplishment, that is past experience, vicarious experience, that is modeling by others, social persuasion, that is coaching and evaluative feedback, and physiological and emotional states. Here comes the confusion. If the measurements are different, how can we still claim that we are talking about the same thing? Another issue with measurements of constructs in the theory of planned behavior is that they are influenced by social desirability. In empirical research, researchers usually use questionnaires or interviews to measure the constructs of intentions, attitudes toward the behavior, subjective norms, and perceived behavioral controls. How people respond to the questionnaires and interview questions can be highly influenced by their desire to present themselves in a socially desirable manner. Just because I claim my intention is X doesn't necessarily mean that's my true intention. Here is a study that applied the theory of planned behavior to study the relationship between trust intent, trusting behavior, and time pressure. In an article titled, I do not want to trust you, but I do, on the relationship between trust intent, trusting behavior, and time pressure, authors differentiated trusting behavior and trust intent. Why? This is because the theory of planned behavior differentiated intentions and behavior. That distinction in the theory informed the authors that the same difference could apply to trust. Therefore, trust intent and trusting behavior should be considered as 2 different constructs. Here, the authors didn't focus on the 3 predictors of intentions, as suggested by the theory of planned behavior. Instead, the authors investigated the link between trust intent and trusting behavior. To do so, they focused on 2 potential factors, time pressure and personal urgency. Time pressure refers to the amount of quantifiable time available. Personal urgency refers to the gravity or importance of the outcome for the individual. In their study, participants were presented with a scenario where they must make an investment decision with little time available to them when they have something important to them on the line. The findings suggest that although lacking intent to trust reduces trusting behavior, it does not become 0, which means trusting behavior still occurs. If I have limited time and it is important for me to trust you, then I still demonstrate trusting behavior towards you, even though I don't want to trust you. The authors also investigated time pressure without a sense of personal urgency. The findings suggest that under low personal urgency, time pressure decreases trusting behavior. This means if I have limited time, which implies high time pressure, and my trust in you is not that important, I tend to decide not to trust you if I don't want to trust you. Here is my question to you all. Voluntary employee turnover means an employee leaves an organization by their own choice. In the United States, the average turnover rate is about 18%. That's about 1 in 5 employees decide to leave the organization by their own choice. The turnover rate of school principal on average is about the same, but the turnover rate of the school principal is higher in schools that serve low-income students of color. Employee turnover is very costly for organization. How do you use the theory of planned behavior to explain voluntary employee turnover? If you want to know more about how to build a theoretical framework for your research, I have published a book titled Demystify Theories, a Workbook for Developing Theoretical Frameworks of Educational Leadership Research. The link of the book is in the description below.